Hi guys, it's September 1st. So we just had a Sunday. It's a new week, it's a new month. We just had a new moon and we're in a new zodiac season, even though it started a week ago. I'm always late for everything. I'm late for work right now as I drive and do this. I apologize. I really wanted to get a video out for Leo season, but life just got in my way, and I think it did for everybody. It's like we were just stuck in a vortex of shit for weeks. Oh my gosh, challenging circumstances everywhere with work, relationships, with health, with money, with other people. God, people have been so nasty lately. Holy hell. Anyway, so as I'm driving here, I just shuffled up my cards and I just wanted to give a quick message about what we can expect this Virgo season. As I now stop to a red light, can you stand it? These people are going to look at me like I'm nuts. And I just dropped the F-bomb. Listen to my indiscriminate language. This is horrible. Oh my God. And I just caught myself in this thing. I'm dressed like a freaking pumpkin. Oh my God. Does it get any better? All right. Anyway, so let's hope. I just want to give a little brief thing. I've been telling my clients for months, like, the energies this year are so rough that I don't anticipate they're going to get better until the last quarter of this year. So what does that mean? That means last quarter would be October, November, December. Well, guess what? We're only in September. So we have not quite made it through the crap yet. I feel like September is going to be the pivotal month. This is where you're going to see changes really start happening. Whether they're, you know, changes that you're implementing yourself, or now the universe is taking the wheel and she's going to start making some changes for you. So some of these might be uncomfortable and very difficult changes to go through. They're not going to feel good. But remember, on the other side of that coin is that despite how painful some changes are to make, it's for your higher good. You have to leave old situations to begin new ones, and you can't do that if you stay stuck in these old patterns. So just rip those band-aids off, get it done with, and open the door for your blessings. It's time. So I shuffled these as I was driving before I started this, so I'm just going to flip them off the top and see what exactly we have going on here. Just let me safely get into the other lane first. Shit, this damn arterial, I'll tell ya. Okay. So, So I think what I'm saying is on point here. We have the Ace of Swords. Ace of Swords is coming up with a new way of thinking, a new thought. It's like a light bulb moment. Like something is finally clear to you. You finally have some clarity on a situation, and it's like I said, a light bulb moment. Like, and this card to me is always, it's a challenge card too. So this is overcoming challenges and difficult situations, being victorious with them. It's also about cutting out the bullshit in your life too. So that sword can be used for good or bad, right? It's a weapon. So you can cut things out of your life, direct conversation here, speaking your truth. That's huge. Oh shit. I told you we weren't out of the storm yet. Okay, it's our favorite card. The Tower. Yikes. Don't even know if I want to keep going with this. All right, so as I was saying, for some of us that have not made these changes voluntarily, the universe is coming in to course correct you. And I'm sorry, it shit hurts. It doesn't feel good. It surprises the hell out of you. You might not even see it coming. There's going to be a sudden change in your life. Your foundation is going to literally crumble underneath you, and that never feels pleasant. But it's going to give you some new insight and some new clarity. It's like this had to happen. Because otherwise you may not have ever made the changes that you need to make. So expect maybe some sudden events that change your way of thinking, that maybe open up the door for a conversation
to life,
cut things out of your life. You know, a relationship might crumble. You might discover something new and have a total change of heart about somebody or a situation. You might decide to cut your losses, basically, with that sword. But something big is about to happen. So forewarned is forearmed. Just expect it. And yeah, it's not going to feel good. This is rough. Five of Cups. There's definitely, you're going to be suffering some losses here. But again, this is to get you to where you need to be. A lot of you, I'm feeling this is with a relationship. A lot of you are going to be leaving relationships this month. Could it be work relationships? Sure, it could be. But I feel this might be more in way of like intimate relationships, husband and wife kind of stuff, long-term relationships. We've tried to live like a traditional family type unit here. So, let's see here. What else can I get from this? Yeah, your foundation is definitely shaking here. There might be some secrets that get revealed, or you discover something that, like I said, really changes your perspective on where things are, where they've been going. The good news is here that Five of Cups turns into Three of Cups. So I feel like there's people that come in to support you and pick you back up. And I also see this as being like something that comes initially as a shock and as something that makes you feel horribly sad and disappointed, quickly turns into celebration. Like, oh my God, thank God this is over. Oh my God. Like, it's almost like a blessing in disguise. Like, there's relief after you grieve the initial loss of whatever this is. Like I said, I think for a lot of us, this is going to be a relationship, actually. Okay, so then you pick yourself up as the Knight of Rods here, and you get moving very quickly again. And actually, that is a moving card. So some of you may find that to get over the loss that you're feeling, you may take a trip. You may travel or journey somewhere, maybe with a group of friends. And then others of you, you know, that is a literal card of moving. So you might be moving out from the home that you've shared. You might leave. To try to find the balance. You have the Justice card now. You're making some sound decisions at this point. For some of you, this might be legal stuff. You might have to get this on paper. So this might be a divorce. This might be, you know, divvying up your assets and whatnot. But I feel like it's in your favor. The Justice card upright is a positive omen that, you know, things will be fair and equitable. And it's also a card of making correct and good decisions. And it's almost like a karma card too. What you have put out is now coming back to you. So maybe good for you, maybe not so good for your partner here. This is all happening to change your perspective on things. You weren't moving. You weren't changing where you were going with that hangman. You're changing your perspective, and there's been a lot of sacrifices. But you were in this holding pattern, and that's the universe is now like breaking you free from that, because you just, I don't know if you gave up with like sitting in the situation or not, but it's here to help you change the way you're thinking. And ding, 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 Lover's card, it's about your relationship. This is definitely impacting a lot of you in the intimate relationship sector. Some final decisions. Wow, we're going to end it here because that's definitely, this is the main theme here. You got the Judgment card and the Fool. That's, you're making decisions. You're going to follow your heart now. You know that you've been stuck in this situation way too long, and this is like a release for you. This is like a, you will have a sudden discovery about this person, about your partner, about your relationship. You're just going to have a sudden like, yeah, I'm not doing this anymore, or you're going to learn something about them that's going to make you want to leave. But you're totally free from this situation now. Like, it's like, I think with these cards, you two almost had some karma. There was some karma here that had to be worked out. I mean, between the Lover's card, the Judgment, and that Justice card, it was a karmic connection. There was a karmic contract between the two of you that you had to finish out for whatever reason. But now you're set on a whole new path and you're free of this. You've cut the ties. So that could even be with relationships with parents here too. You know, I say romantic relationships, these are very important relationships. These are soul contract relationships that are leaving. So I know for me, I've been expecting something with my dad to happen. Him and I have a very horrible, horrible relationship. He was an abuser and I cut him out of my life, but I feel like he may be nearing the end of his life, and that could be what's going on here. There might be some loss with some parents here that, you know, we've had these karmic connections with. So whether they're passing to the other side or we're just deciding to cut them out of our lives, these heavy karmic relationships that we've been holding on to that are getting us nowhere are about to leave. So September seems like a really big month for this. Again, timing is really tough with tarot. I'm going to say it's for this Virgo season that these events occur, but it might just be the buildup before these events actually happen. But you're going to see it. I think you're kind of seeing some of this coming already. A lot of you already know this is happening. So I've babbled too much. I'm late for work. I'm in the parking lot. I gotta go. Hopefully I can post something else. You know, I want to do this a little bit more frequently than once a month or once every other month. So I'm totally winging it. I don't know how I'm doing it. I don't have a plan. So I'm just going to go with the flow like I do with everything else. All right. Great, guys. Thanks for listening.